In the next problem, we will discuss anharmonic oscillator. Here the idea is that the potential experienced by this harmonic oscillator is not simply quadratic potential. In a harmonic oscillator, we know that the potential is half kx square. Okay, now let us apply a perturbation, something like k prime x raised to 4. This is called a quartic term. X raised to 4 term is called quartic term. So we apply a quartic perturbation. So since the total potential is now different from quadratic potential, harmonic oscillator type potential, this is no longer a harmonic oscillator, it's an unharmonic oscillator. So let us see. So the only way to solve it is by approximation method. Exact solution is not possible. Let us try this time independent perturbation method. And using this, let us try to calculate the first order correction in energy. So our aim is to calculate the first order correction in energy. So En1 is equal to n v prime n, correct? Where v prime is k prime x raised to 4 n. K prime is a constant, I can take it outside, n x raised to 4 n. So one way to do is, see, this is, you know how to write x square in terms of a and a diagram, right? X square is equal to some h cross by 2m omega into a dagger square plus 2n plus I, where n is number operator, plus a square. So you can take that, that is x square, then you can operate it twice. So you will get x square into x square is to 4, and you can expand it and you can do that. That is one way, you can try that. And I am here trying as different way. This you can write as n. X raised to 4 is simply x square acting twice, right? X raised to 4 means x square acting twice. Now here, let me introduce an identity in between the two x square. We know that this Kepton, the set of eigenstates of the harmonic oscillator Hamiltonian, this Kepton form a complete set. Okay, then we can introduce the completeness condition here. Okay, what is the completeness condition? Summation over, instead of n, let me use another the index. So summation over some m, ket vector m, bra vector m is equal to identity. This is the projection operator. Summation over the projection operator of along all the states will give you identity. So that completeness condition I can introduce here. Therefore, this I can write as k prime into, if I write the summation first, summation over m, okay, then you have bra vector n x square, then comes this ket vector and bra vector, so we have a ket vector m here, a bra vector m here, then this x square will come, then n, correct? In terms of this identity, I have introduced a summation over m, ket vector m, bra vector m. Summation over m, I can simply take out. So you have two matrix elements. Instead of a single matrix element, you have two matrix elements. What are they? N x square m and m x square m. Immediately you can see that one is the complex conjugate of the other. Okay. N x square m is the complex conjugate of m x square m. You are simply interchanging the bra vector and ket vector. So with this we can write as the modulus square of any one of them. Okay, so I can simply write this as k prime summation over m, let us say modulus square of this one. So we have m x square n modulus square. Okay, don't confuse this with the expression in second order correction in energy. Okay, the important difference is that in second order correction in energy, this summation does not involve m. Sorry, n. M not equal to n, that condition is there. Here, summation involves all m states because it is a completeness condition. So, all m states are there, including m equal to n. That is one thing. And the second thing is that the denominator, the energy difference denominator, En0 minus Em0, it is not there. So, this is different. Okay, even though the term looks like that. Now, this type of a quantity we have evaluated in the previous calculation of harmonic oscillator. So, we can easily use that result here. So, what is this m x square n? The expression for x square, we know how to expand it. So, we have x involves some square root of h cross by 2m omega. So, x square involves h cross by 2m omega. There will be three terms, m a dagger square n. We have written this in the previous calculation. So, I am directly writing m 2n plus I n plus m a square n. Right? In the previous calculation, this term was 0 because m and n are different. But in this summation, m and n can be different, m and n can be same. So, all the three terms are non-zero. That is the important thing. So, let us evaluate these terms. We have h cross by 2m omega. This term will be, I am directly writing down, when a dagger square operates twice on n, you will get root of, first time you will get n root of n plus 1, second time you will get root of n plus 2. Okay, the remaining thing will be m n plus 2. Plus 2n plus I operating on n, we get 2n plus 1. So we have 2n plus 1 m n plus, then this will be when a square operates twice on n, you will get root of n into n minus 1 m n minus 2. Okay, we know that this term is nothing but Kronecker delta m comma n plus 2, and this term is Kronecker delta m comma n, and this term is Kronecker delta m comma n minus 2. Correct? This is m x square n, and we have to take the square of this one. When you take the square of this one, there are three terms in the expression for m x square n. When you take the modulus square, means you have to multiply this with n x square n, complex conjugate with n and m interchanged. So, similarly, you can write n x square m, okay? Only thing is that n and m will be interchanged. So, you will get three expressions with three Kronecker delta. So, there will be three terms like this. There will be three other terms with m and n interchanged. Then, you will be having nine terms. In these nine terms, cross terms will again be zero. Okay. Let us not say cross terms. You can show that only three terms will be non-zero. The reason is that here this condition, there is a summation here. So, in these nine terms, for example, if you take this term, the condition is that m should be equal to n plus 2. So, this can be multiplied with a term which is having the same condition, m is equal to n plus 2, delta m comma n plus 2. So, eventually, you will see a term containing delta m minus 2 comma n. Okay, delta m minus 2 comma n in the other three terms. How do you get that is, in the other three terms m and n are interchanged. So, one term will contain delta n comma n plus 2, delta n comma m, which is same as this one. Then delta n comma m minus 2. So, you the delta function will be delta m minus 2 comma n. So, which will be equal to this one? Delta m comma n plus 2. So, this type of a term you can multiply with this type of a term with the condition is that m is equal to n plus 2. When you put and here also you will be having expression in terms of m and n are interchanged. in the complex conjugate term. So you will be having a term like root of m into m minus 1. When you put m is equal to n plus 2, this will be n plus 2, this will be m plus 2 minus 1, which is this. Okay, so my point is that even though you will be having 9 terms, 6 terms will be 0 and 3 terms will be non-zero, and those 3 terms will be just like the square of this one, square of this one and square of this one. Okay, I am not working it out. You just write down the complex conjugate term n x square m just like this, then n and m will be interchanged. You will get 3 terms like this in term with n and m interchanged. Multiply the 3 terms here and 3 terms there, and you will get 9 terms, and you can show that 6 of them are 0 because this delta function will not satisfy 2 mutually exclusive conditions. Okay, that summation will not satisfy 2 mutually exclusive conditions in delta function. Kronecker delta function. Okay, so it is the net result will be just like taking the square of this one and this one. Okay, this you can show. So I will just write down. What you get is k prime. Then you have to take the square of this. So the square of this one, we have h cross square by 4. M square omega square, then you will get square of this one, and the condition will be the same, delta m comma n plus 2. So you can be assured that in this summation somewhere that condition will be satisfied, so that this term will be 1, that Kronecker delta will be 1. So we have two such terms will be the square root of n plus 1 n plus 2 into the same thing. So we have n plus 1 n plus 2. Here you have two such terms, that means 2n plus 1 whole square, 2n plus 1 into 2n plus 1. There is no root here. There are two such terms. So we have n into n minus 1. Okay. Okay. So this is k prime h cross square divided by 4m square omega square. This is n square plus 3n plus 2 plus, here we have 4n square plus 4n plus 1 plus, here we have n square minus n, right? So we have n square plus 4n square plus n square, 6n square, 3n plus 4n, 7n minus n plus 6n, 2 plus 1, 3. Okay. That's equal to k prime h cross square by 4m square. 4m square omega square. I am taking 6 outside. We have n square plus n plus 1 by 2. Okay. This is your answer. We can slightly rewrite it in a neat fashion. So k prime into 6 by 4 is 3 by 2. H cross square by m square omega square. This term I can write as n square plus n plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2. So I am introducing a plus 1 by 4 and minus 1 by 4 here in order to make these three terms into a perfect square. So we have k prime 3 by 2. H cross square by m square omega square. These three terms together I can write as n plus half whole square. Correct? And this is minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 is plus 1 by 4. And further, we know k is equal to root of, k is equal to m omega square. Suppose I multiply numerator and denominator with an omega square. So we have an omega square here, and here you will be having an omega raised to 4. This m square omega raised to 4 I can write as k square. Okay, where k is the original force constant of the oscillator. This k prime is not a force constant, it is a constant, that's all. So this is equal to 3 by 2 k prime divided by this m square omega raised to 4 I can write as k square. Okay, then you have n plus half whole square plus 1 by 4 h cross omega whole square. This is the first order correction energy of a, this we can call a an unharmonic oscillator, or we can call a quartic oscillator, where the perturbation is a quartic perturbation. Okay, a harmonic oscillator with a quartic perturbation. Okay, this is the first order correction energy.